This is Dana Susan Beasley of AngelArts.biz, and I'm continuing a series on falling in love with the bridegroom. Before I get started, if you would like to get my complete falling in love with the bridegroom devotional for free, check the link in the description below. This devotional will teach you how to have quiet times and give you ample scriptures to spend in devoted study. Now let's get to today's devotional, and I will start with prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, help us to walk in wholehearted devotion for you and forgive us for those times when we walk away and we turn our backs on you and find life in something else other than you. Restore us and bring us shepherds after our own heart, and just thank you for your great mercy. And it's in your precious name I pray. Amen. All right, so today I'm going to be reading from Jeremiah 3, and if you would pause this now and read the whole chapter, and I will be reading from verses 11 through, let's see, I lost my place. Let's see, 11 through 18. All right, and I'll be reading from the English Standard Version. Friends, this is the word of the Lord. And the Lord said to me, "Faithless Israel has shown herself more righteous than treacherous Judah. Go and proclaim these words toward the north and say, 'Return, faithless Israel,' declares the Lord. 'I will not look on you in anger, for I am merciful,' declares the Lord. 'I will not be angry forever, only acknowledge your guilt, that you rebelled against the Lord your God and scattered your favors among foreigners under every green tree, and that you have not obeyed my voice,' declares the Lord. 'Return, O faithless children,' declares the Lord, 'for I am your master. I will take you, one from a city and two from a family, and I will bring you to Zion. And I will give you shepherds after my own heart, who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. And when you have multiplied and been fruitful in the land, in those days, declares the Lord, they shall no more say, the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. It shall not come to mind or be remembered or missed. It shall not be made again. At that time, Jerusalem shall be called the throne of the Lord, and all nations shall gather to it, to the presence of the Lord in Jerusalem. And they shall no more stubbornly follow their own evil heart. In those days, the house of Judah shall join the house of Israel, and together they shall come from the land of the north to the land that I gave your fathers for a heritage." And once again, read that whole chapter so you get the full context. So here are my thoughts about that passage. About what the bridegroom, oh my goodness, what the bridegroom is like. God is like a jilted husband who has an unfaithful wife. He is a jealous God. And, as our husband, he deserves to be respected and loved with a wholly devoted heart. Yet we leave him for other lovers, and then when it doesn't work out, when we're in trouble because of our bad decisions, we want him back for his help. Yet he forgives and wants to love and shepherd us. One day he'll make it right. It reminds me of when my husband and I were dating years and years ago, and we came to a rough spot in our relationship, and he didn't seem like he was 100% on board. Our relationship, the idea of getting married, was very confusing. And so we hadn't talked for a few months, and we reunited the day before my birthday, my 30th birthday. And we met, and I told him, I told him, God deserves wholehearted devotion from me, and I deserve nothing less from you. And that challenged him. And so the next day, when we did get together for my actual birthday, we went to lunch in the car. He told me, some very vulnerable things he had never said before, and he started to want to change, and he started to make some changes. And so he did eventually be wholeheartedly devoted to me. It's not been an easy journey over the last 25 years or more, and I know the pain. Oh, there is so much pain in what God is describing. You know, the jilted lover, it's just hard. And yet that is what God experiences when we go after other gods, other idols. It just hurts the heart of God, just like it hurts our heart when our loved ones betray us. And yet he loves us and he's merciful and he brings us shepherds after our own heart. He provides a way of reconciliation. He's an amazing God and he deserves wholehearted devotion from us. So what's my response? Well, obviously wholehearted devoted to him. Practically, to me, that means seeking his will above all in every situation. And right now, I'm facing quite a humdinger of a decision, of a circumstance, and I just have to keep trusting in him that he'll tell me what to do or he'll work it out, or both of those. So, and then what was I meditating, or what was God saying to me as I meditated on this passage? Die to self when it comes to these circumstances. And that's what I pray, that in the midst of the circumstance I'm in, that it would be his will and not mine. And that whatever happens, I'd be an example of forgiveness, restoration, and God's love. All right, so I'm going to end with prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for your mercy and for your shepherd's heart and for your reconciliation and your love. Help us to be wholeheartedly devoted to you. Thank you that you do not give up on us, and you are here to help us. So just give us wisdom in whatever circumstances that we are facing, and help us to be light bearers of your image, and to share your love, and to be always wholly devoted to you. In your precious name I pray, amen. All right. So that's all for the day. Tomorrow I'll continue my series on falling in love with the bridegroom. And again, if you want the free devotional, check the link below. Do you want to go deeper with the scriptures? Find out more about my Becoming God's Bride Bible study. Check that out also in the description box below. So with that, I'm going to leave you with my favorite blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. This is Dana Susan Beasley of Angel Arts.biz. Together, may we reach new heights in our lives and beyond.